So welcome to the 4,686th Artist Spotlight with none other than Yannick. Super excited for this one. I haven't had a ton of time to dive into his art. I am obviously blown away already. But without further ado, I'm going to jump into the profile here for Yannick. I'm going to try not to fumble around too much. So here we go. Hey, German artist focused on psychedelic cubism, abstract art, and psychedelic art, mainly influenced by artists like Alex Gray, John Speaker, Pablo Picasso, Hunter Wasser, oh man, this is going to get bad, Sonia, Delaney, Turk, and someone else. I love to create characters or fictional sceneries, societies, and to paint, draw them into existence. Oh, that's cool. Spirituality, music, and nature are the main sources of my inspiration, back to my favor for my psychedelic culture and interest in forms and shapes. Wow, this is incredible. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Let me just pull up your, so you have a presentation for us prepared. Am I at the top? Is this the, oh, here's the first one.
Yeah, cool. Exactly.
I can use the arrows and everything. So welcome to the spotlight. We're super excited to have you. Welcome, community members. Really happy with the turnout. I always love seeing the regular faces. So this is the spotlight. So you want to just jump into it?
Yeah, sure. So I think it would be good idea to start with a small introduction of myself, if you're fine with it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, perfect. So yeah, my name is Yannick Röpke. I'm 20 years old.
Wait, 2-0? Like, sorry, I mean, 2-0? 20?
28. What did I say?
Oh, 28?
Yeah.
Wow, yeah. That's still really young. Sorry, that's incredible. All right, I won't interrupt anymore.
Yeah, it's fine, don't worry. So yeah, I'm 28 years old, and I'm a German artist from Hildesheim. Hildesheim is a small town which is located in the northern part of Germany. So maybe you guys know Hanover. And yeah, Hanover is the next bigger city close to Hildesheim. So it's probably a bit easier to locate it. I'm currently currently in my master's studies to become a teacher for arts and economics for secondary school.
Oh.
And yeah, besides I'm working as an artist while I'm combining traditional art. So I mainly do paintings and drawings with a digital art. And yeah, my artworks, or I would say my artworks are connected to psychedelic art, definitely psychedelic art, abstract art, and psychedelic cubism. So wow. I don't know whether this art genre really exists, psychedelic cubism, but...
It does now.
yeah, that's the way I call it.
I like it, psychedelic cubism. That's really cool. Like, yeah. I'm a big fan.
Thanks.
And so is this psychedelic cubism?
No, I wouldn't call this one psychedelic cubism. I think it's more more connected to psychedelic art.
Okay, yeah. Can you give us kind of like a rundown of this piece here and like how it came about and kind of like the story behind it?
Yes, of course. So it's called The Chief. So originally it's a painting. You see it on the left side. And these are the original colors. And yeah, the painting got inspired by a psytrance wave while I was working at a backpackers hostel in India. So I worked directly in Goa. And I met a guy during the party who looked like a shaman, and he had this very very special spiritual presence, and he was totally covered in spiritual clothes, and I was really impressed by him and by the whole party too. So I started to remember this moment and try to manifest my experience in a portrait.
Is that from memory, or did you actually take a photo?
No, it's from memory.
Wow! Yeah. And how accurate do these normally? Like, so if it's from memory, like, does this actually kind of resemble who you saw in that experience?
Not really. I wouldn't say that it's I think, yeah, it's not the face of the guy I saw. It's more like
how you
like
felt.
face re representing the feelings I had
Wow.
at the party. Yeah.
Do you always,
So,
I already have so many questions. Do you always draw
yeah, of
from
course.
memory?
No,
No?
not only.
Is that kind of like a
It
special
depends.
thing?
It depends. Sometimes I really have a clear picture or photo I'm starting to draw. Well, yeah, especially when I'm starting to draw portraits. And you also, yeah, you're going to see one portrait
What?
where it fits. And but
Yeah,
sometimes I also just start drawing a face.
yeah.
Time or step by step, it turns into yeah a special character.
Wow.
So, for example, yeah, the Tropical Fever character, this is out of a memory too. So there's no special picture I had in front of me to get inspired by.
So, what do you enjoy more, doing things from memory or having like a reference? Or is it just like there's not really one's better than the other, you just do both?
It's hard to say that I prefer one thing. So to for me, it was very important to start learning it from the beginning while having something in front of me. So, for example, having a photo in front of me, or I did a lot of drawing classes at university where we had naked people in front of us. So we started to drawing those bodies and the shapes. And it's very important for me to have this kind of basis to start creating those fictional characters out of my memory. So it yeah, it's kind of connected, and there isn't really one kind of process I prefer. It's both very important for my work, so yeah.
Sorry, my brain just like you just took me someplace. I'm back now. I guess like the reason why I'm so curious because like drawing from memory and I've heard of I believe there was one other artist on the Terra Virtual platform that does something sort of similar. Like I always am curious like what gets like what are we revealing? Like it's always cool to see things from the directly from the life experience of a person coming from their mind and then what the output is always kind of like exciting to look at because it's their interpretation. It's
Yeah.
not like you're not using something to aid you in that interpretation. You're just creating that interpretation from your own perspective and with your skills, you know, with where you're at. So,
Yeah,
I love that.
exactly.
I love artists that can do that, and I think obviously that's in your wheelhouse, and it's really cool.
Yeah, thank you. So, you may can go back
Oh, sorry.
one page. Yeah, that was fine. For example, this one, it's called a Tropical Fever, and it's also inspired by my small journey to India. So it was the first time I went out of Europe. Before I traveled, yeah, a lot of countries in Europe, and I had a really great time. But yeah, the trip to India was the first experience really out of Europe. And when I left the airport in Mumbai, I got hit really hard by the humidity and the temperature. And before I started my journey, I was kind of frightened about the mosquitoes in India, because in India you can get like really hard diseases like dengue fever. And yeah, it's always like, yeah, when you come from Europe and you go to a country like this, you're a bit frightened about getting those kind of diseases. So this one, called Tropical Fever, is inspired by yeah the fear about getting
Yeah.
a mosquito infection.
You know,
Exactly.
wow, that's actually. Now that you say that, like I can get that sense of like what is trying to be depicted, like the certain level of anxiety, but yet, wow, like that's, I don't know how you did it, but you definitely did it really well.
Yeah, thank
Anyway,
you.
sorry, let's keep rolling.
Yeah, it's fine. And yeah, on this page, so the Tropical Fever example and the example before, the chief, there you can see some kind of process I'm doing with my artwork. So on the left side,
Oh.
you see the original painting, the original color scheme, and then I start to to make a high resolution scan,
Wow.
and
Ritual
afterwards start.
edition. I love that
Yeah,
actually. That
exactly.
And, is this one available? Yeah, then, or was it? Was this one of the ones you sold on the Terra Virtua?
Yeah, the Witcher edition. Exactly.
Oh, that's cool.
And another edition, an animated one.
No, I have to see that. Wow.
Yeah. So my basic concept about the art.
I don't know. My art book. You somehow with just colors like did some like you made it feel so psychedelic. And I don't know how colors do that. Like, how do colors convey a feeling like that? It just blows my mind a little bit. Because you have the same photo, just with different colors. And yet, one conveys such a different message. And can you explain to me how that happens? Because I have no clue.
Yeah, I guess, one of the main reasons is that I'm really influenced by psychedelic art, so I dove deep into it for a lot of years and a lot of practice behind it, and after some time you really start developing your own kind of aesthetical language, I would call it. Like,
whoa.
This and when you combine it with all the experience you have, especially a psychedelic experience, you kind of
wow.
You kind of know how to combine shapes and colors to have this kind of outcome.
And that's why you sell out instantly?
Well, not instantly, but
I
can't complain.
I'm saying
for everyone who showed interest in my art and bought a piece.
Yeah,
I feel very honored.
Mark your calendars. You say the 21st? April 21st?
22nd.
22nd is when the next drop is happening. So that's exciting.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, so you did this. So you're showing us you did the same thing. Sorry, I didn't interrupt, but okay.
Yeah, so on the left side, you see the original painting. So it's usually a painting on paper or on canvas. Those two paintings are made on paper. It's around about 30 x 40 centimeters. And yeah, on the left side, you see the digital editing. So,
whoa.
Yeah, so I use different brushes and different effects for certain shapes within the image, and I started to turn them into digital new artworks.
Do you always start with physical, like medium?
Not always. So later on in the presentation, you'll see some purely digital paintings.
Ooh.
But often I prefer, because I'm really connected to the traditional side of art, and it's always, or it always will be part of my work and of my personality. So
Can I ask a personal question about like digital art? Like, how do you deal with the distractions from notifications and Twitter? And like, how do you get yourself in a place where you can spend whatever amount of time is necessary to create something like this?
Yeah, that's a pretty good question. I think the only way that it really worked for me was to slow down my social media activity for a bit, because it consumes so much time and I have so much stuff to do. I dedicate my life to art. Like, I'm doing art every day for several hours.
Wow.
And besides, I have to focus on my studies to become a teacher for secondary school in the subject arts and economics. So, I have to set some priorities. These kinds of things are definitely my first two priorities.
You definitely sound like the most calculated artist I've met. Like, it just seems like you're very well timed. You're very, like, you plan out your, like, everything you do is like seems just so calculated. Am I wrong there, or like it's just you? Wow. I can appreciate that more than most, because I'm kind of like the opposite of calculated.
Same goes with me. The time management is really my enemy.
We were talking about that. Time is the worst. So annoying.
It even gets harder when you have like three priorities, like social media and artworks and studying. So I said, okay, to improve my time management a little bit, I just get rid of not the whole social media stuff, but I have to decrease it, because as you already mentioned, it's kind of a really hard distraction sometimes. And yeah, so I have to set like special times when I focus on social media, and the rest is spent for art and for studying.
Yeah. Do you have those scenarios where someone's trying to message you and like, listen, this is my art time. I can't be engaging in your drama, Sarah or Todd or whatever. She's a name that is, what is a common German name? Like just the most average German name.
Yeah, another good question.
Put you on the spot.
I think a very common female German name is Laura.
Okay, I don't have time for your drama, Laura.
yeah. And the special, very common male name would be good question. Maybe Timo.
Timo? Can't have time for Timo's drama.
It's a more modern name, but
it's funny because I say this because I know that the creative process is more delicate than people realize. And I say delicate. Some people are good at managing it. I'm like a snowflake when it comes to the creative process. My phone will ring and I'll just be mad at the person the whole day because I thought I was going to create something sick. And then I'll be like, that person ruined it. So I was just curious how you like managed the noise and how you're able to still create such like wonderful art when the society's just so noisy, man. So that was my question, I guess.
On the other hand, I have a lot of time right now because I'm not really able to attend the school I'm teaching right now. So it's kind of an internship I'm having right now in my master studies. But I'm not allowed to be there in presence because due to the Corona pandemic. And all the other stuff is also locked down over here in my area. So there's nothing much to do instead of sitting at home and doing arts.
Wow. No, I mean, obviously, it's a good time spin for you because obviously we're getting to see some really incredible stuff. So I'm not mad that you're in lockdown. I'll say that much. All right, let me keep going here. What are we looking at?
Oh yeah, this guy is called the Skeptical Helmut.
I don't know why I like him already. Like it's just.
Yeah, Helmut is also a very common name in Germany. But it's more settled down in the it's more used in my grandpa's generation.
Yeah, I feel like this guy does not put up with drama. He's just like very no nonsense. He's seen enough where he's tired and he just wants to do his job. And like he wishes everyone would just be normal. He's tired of the pandemic. He's just like kind of just annoyed, but still sustaining. Is that good? Did I get it?
Yeah, that's great introduction, Russ. Great introduction.
Or tell me where I missed.
Well, another story behind this small guy is he needs special care. So he loves to eat rainbow pasta, and he's also in love with ice cold beer.
So
a lot of people like ice cold beer. Yeah. There's going to be an animated version of it. It's called The Skeptical Helmut.
No way.
Pasta Rage Quit.
I love him already, man. I didn't know he had a personality.
yes. And the animated version, he's very seething from the inside because you forgot to supply him with rainbow pasta and ice cold beer, so yeah, he's very close to explode and to turn your apartment into dust. So.
What is happening? I can't even, like, I don't know if I'm supposed to take you seriously or if I'm being trolled right now. Like, this is...
No, it's like a funny storytelling guy. This kind
it's
of
it's wonderful. Like, I feel like I'm going on a little micro-adventure. Like, this guy has so much depth to him, and I knew he did. I knew there were secrets. Like, he was... That's funny. Yeah. Is there more of these guys, or is it the first? Or
I made a series of portrait studies, including three different pieces. So one of them is the Helmut one, And another one is called the Manneke, which is already sold on Terra Virtua. And yeah, we're going to talk about it later in the presentation.
Okay.
But this, yeah, those two artworks are connected. They are part of one portrait
series. I don't even want to go on, man. This guy's like got a piece of my heart now.
Perfect.
Yeah.
That was the goal. Yeah. Ah, yeah.
Wow. So,
yeah, there you go. This one's called The Oneness.
Wow.
Yeah, it's, maybe take a second to look at it.
I really, honestly, I don't even have any questions. I'm still trying to absorb it, honestly. How much time, it just, there's so much detail and careful thought. Yeah. Like, I don't even know where you would begin.
Yeah, so I think I started out with the face in the center.
Uh-huh.
So with the juicy lips. So this face was the starting point.
Uh-huh.
And I think in total, so this painting is made with acrylic colors, and it's also 30x40 centimeters, I guess.
Wow.
Yeah, should be like this. And after I painted it with acrylic colors, I added some shapes and some lines with artist ink.
Why am I getting chill bumps, man? Like, what is your art doing to me? It's freaking me out. It's in a good way, though. Like, I'm like pleasantly entering into this like universe that my eyes are just like darting around trying to solve these, like, I'm not trying to solve anything. I'm just like appreciating all these different areas of this piece.
Yeah, thank you so much, Russ. I would like to add a quote by Alex Gray, which is one of the most known psychedelic artists nowadays. I guess maybe you heard about him.
No, but I'm going to look him up.
Yeah, you definitely should. He's beyond any expectations, just a pure genius, really. Totally impressing. And the quote, I'm just going to read it down. The infinite vibratory levels, the dimensions of interconnectedness are without end. There's nothing independent. All beings and things are residents in our awareness. So that's kind of a quote, I think, that really fits for this artwork. And I'm always getting excited and definitely inspired by Alex Gray.
Yeah.
So,
and do you like that? Is it strange that I like see this as truth? Like, it's strange. Like, people are always trying to decide like what is and what isn't in reality, you know? But like, when you say stuff like that, like, my inner being just agrees without any sort of like dialogue, you know what I mean? Or I don't know why I just immediately agree with the sentiment.
Yeah.
Can you tell me why I do?
Well, I would love to, but I guess it really depends on every individual. Of course, it depends on the whole life experience.
And then skepticism, tradition.
You're connected with, exactly. So, yeah.
Okay. Maybe we'll have to talk offline. Here we go. Oh, black and white. Wow.
Yeah. These are black
you
and
start
white.
With black and white, right?
Yeah, exactly. So the concept behind my artwork collections on Terra Virtua is to have a basic common version, which is mostly in black and white with a small touch of blue, which is just my aesthetical preparation.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have like another version of it, like a colored version, digitally changed version, maybe some effects, maybe some special brushes to increase the psychedelic effect or whatever effect I'm trying to increase in this case.
Yeah.
And then you have the last version, which would be an animated version, colored and animated version.
Yeah. You know what? Like, this makes me think of, like, you ever see those therapeutic apps where you get these color pages and you get to choose a color and just tap in the area and it fills it up like a little paint bucket?
Yeah.
I honestly feel like looking at your art and just putting the colors in places would be the most like therapeutic thing I've ever experienced. I don't know. Like, my mind just went there, and I'm not even mad about it. Like, I really think that, like, you're doing something special when it comes to, I don't know. I don't know how I'm feeling so calm in chaos. I think that's what's puzzling me right now. Like, cause, like, if you just look at these pieces, you're going to immediately think, like, wow, that's chaotic. But then you look a little bit longer and, like, wait a minute, there's a lot of order to this. And then you look longer and you're like, somebody put a lot of thought into the placement of these shapes. And then, like, honestly, like, it just, the longer you, like, look at it, the more you kind of, like, appreciate it. And I think it's because you put so much thought into it. Like, you carefully put this together without any, like, you didn't, like, skip any parts. You did it, like, just, it was such careful attention, it looks like.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I have another good quote to it by Terence McKenna regarding the chaos aspect. I think I also mentioned it for the image description of Under the Surface, which you see on the left side.
Mm-hmm.
So it's Terence McKenna quoted or said chaos is what we've lost touch with. This is why it is given a bad name. It's feared by the dominant archetype of our world, which is ego, which clenches because its existence is defined in terms of control. So this was a quote I really appreciate, and I think it really kind of fits the artworks I'm doing.
Do you have a podcast? I'm going to just go ahead and subscribe to your podcast. even if you don't have one, I'd be your first subscriber. I think you broke me. Do you break many students during your teachings? Like, they just can't leave. They're just stuck in their seat. They're like, all right, Nick, time to go to your next class. Like, they're like, I can't. Like, I don't know what, like, life is anymore.
hopefully not that.
I don't know. I don't. Maybe they don't get it. You're tapping into some, like, universal truths, I think, and I'm really enjoying it. I think you're like, I love this universal. It's not even a concept. It's just, I love what you're exposing, and and I think this needs more appreciation in our world, in our society, in all the clamor and noise. I feel like people. I wish more people could be more mindful. Because this is good stuff, man. Nobody can deny this is, like, this is just good stuff. And it's good because you put your careful attention towards it, and we can see that. Yeah. So I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm just like, people are like, move on, Russ, stop, you know. But okay, we'll keep going.
Yeah, Russ, thank you so much for your kind words. I hugely appreciate it, really. Means a lot to me when people get their touch this kind of way.
Mm.
And hopefully I can touch my students or my pupils later in this kind of way too. Because I guess, I totally agree with you that kind of psychedelic art should be mentioned more often nowadays, because it has kind of a really bad image. Well, of course, it depends on what kind of country you live. But Germany, it's kind of difficult, especially if you want to become a teacher. I think the times, they are changing, to quote Bob Dylan, and it's time for some new fresh air.
Oh, man. I'm going to come to you for quotes. Like, I'm not even going to try and come up with my own. I know you have the best ones. So, just, do you have, like, a quote book? Like, I could, like, or, like, your recommendations for quotes? Like, you got some, like, heavy hitters, like, and I need some of those in my back pocket.
Well, that's my small secret. So,
can I join that secret club somehow? Like, and maybe the community, if they're cool too, they can join.
that all depends on the outcome of
in the end. So, I'm intrigued, man. Like, you've got me on the edge of my seat. Like, you're so cool, calm, and collective because catch on. Anyway, we'll keep going.
Please go back one.
Oh,
one
sorry. Page. Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine. So this one's called the Safari Tourist, and I'm planning to to publish a whole collection about this little dude on Terra Virtua.
So I love him, man.
He's going to have a very special psychedelic and kind of altering experience.
Wow.
And the whole collection will deal is going to deal with with his adventure. And I would like to show all my different styles, like painting, drawing, digital art, combined in this collection.
Yeah.
Telling the story of the safari tourist having his great adventure.
Can I ask a question that I don't think I've asked anyone, but I'm just genuinely curious if you hold this perspective of, do you believe you have an artistic fingerprint that's unique to you, or do you believe that you're just exposing what's already there?
Difficult question. I guess, I heard a lot of times that my style is kind of very unique.
Which I concur. For sure.
Yeah, thank you. I think so too. But it took so much time, so much years, and so much hours of practicing to develop my own kind of artistical language. And
your interpretation is unique, and that's your fingerprint, but you're drawing from the universal truths, that are free for everyone.
Yeah. Yeah, wow. that's a good formulation.
Wow. I think I just had an epiphany there, and I'm I have to take a moment, take it all in. That's some deep. That I don't think the community knows how deep this stuff is, but I'm having the time of my life right now. all right.
Yeah.
Let me know if you want me to go further.
Yeah, you can go further.
Okay.
So yeah, this one, this one is also a very special piece to me personally. So it's called Pablo's Cubistic One Night Chicken. It's also an ink drawing. And in the center, so the face in the center, you see Pablo Picasso. It's a portrait of him. And all those crazy characters you see surrounding him, like the bull underneath his chin, is a little bit to the left. And there's a guitar player. I don't know whether you spotted it, but there's also a guitar player in. And all the characters you see surrounding the face of Pablo Picasso are already shown in his paintings. So in a kind of selection of his paintings I chose, and I just interpreted it in my own way of psychedelic cubism. So this is a perfect example for my idea of psychedelic cubism.
Wow. That's all I got, man. You want to keep going?
Yeah, and I'm not sure. So most of the people don't see it, but after I explain it, they usually see nothing else than this. So have you spotted the sex scene in this?
No, I'm still stuck on Pablo's face.
but that's perfect, because the sex scene I'm talking about is located in his face.
No.
Yeah, it is. I'm not sure. Can you may zoom in a bit?
Okay, sure. Yeah, let me see if I can do it with my.
Yeah, but yeah, perfect.
Oh wait, why did I highlight it?
Yeah, a little less.
How do I zoom out? Oh no! Here we go. This is where we all start falling apart. Russ, what are you doing? View, full screen, and then zoom here. All right, there we go. Oh wait, further.
One step further. Yeah, okay. One step less, sorry.
Oh, yeah, this is why it's fun, because I get to mess up a lot.
that's perfect. So, okay. Let's focus on his nose. So, on his nose, or his nose, so the left and the right.
Oh, I see what's on the right. I see what's happening on the right of the nose.
Yeah. It's so the nose turns into the breasts of the woman he has his one-night stand with. So that's why it's called Pablo's Cubistic One-Night Chicken. So on the right side of the nose, you see kind of drops, which which symbolizing mother's milk. And if you go go up the nose and the check his left eyebrow. So this exactly. So this is kind of a woman's face or woman's face. So she turns her head to the right. So you you look on it sideways. And the black parts of his eyebrows, the really dark dark parts.
Is her hair?
Yeah, exactly. And then you see her nose and her mouth and her chin, but you don't see her eyes. So her eyes are covered by her hair. And the shadows of the or the shadows around the right eye of Pablo's portrait. Yeah, exactly. These this is kind of her right arm, and on the other hand side you have you also have the shadow behind his left or underneath his left eye.
Wow.
Yeah, this turns into another arm of her. So yeah, and those kind of arms reminds me a little bit of of a chicken wing. So that's why it's called one-eyed chicken. Also.
Wow. Man.
Exactly. And then you go down.
Down.
Yes. Sorry to interrupt you.
No, no, you're fine.
Then you go down. So the nose turns into his breast. You see small pieces of small parts of mother's milk coming out of her breast on the right side. Then the area around his mouth turns into like white rounded hips of her.
I see.
Yeah. And when you focus on her on his chin. On the chin of Pablo Picasso, you see like a very tiny, small vagina, and directly underneath it, you see the penis going towards the vagina, and turning into the eyebrow and the nose of
right here.
Small, like a cyclope face. Yeah, exactly.
Wow. So see it right here.
Wow. So this is a small one-night stand hidden in Pablo's cubistic.
And you wouldn't know, like you, I feel like you could get it, but it's just you'd have to take a little time to like unravel that. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I really love to hide those small kind of secrets, or well, let's call it Easter eggs.
Is this is this the inside of something here?
No, not really.
Okay.
So
I'm like, I want to do my own investigations. Like,
yeah, go for it.
Well, I mean, I don't want to embarrass myself, so I'll save it. So here, let me zoom out again. I know we got like 13 minutes ish, but we don't have to rush. I just want to like keep an eye. I want to have time for community questions if they have any.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's see. We go there. Oh, there we go. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
The depth in this one. You've got some, like, you've got the depth skills on lock. Wow.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. So this one is a good example for having a photo in front of me. And
I want to buy this one so bad. I don't know what, like, is this already sold out?
No, it's not even live, so it's
thank goodness,
which goes live on on the 22nd.
Don't tell no one knows. Nobody knows the drop is happening when, so I can get in and make sure to snag one. I get, dude, this one, like, I don't know why it resonates with. I want to print this one out, like, and put it on my wall.
Yeah. So there's going to be two versions of it in the new collection. So one version you see in front of you on the screen. So, and the other one will be an animated version, which turned out very psychedelic. It's going to mirror the faces in different ways, and it's very vivid. And
wow, my goodness,
exactly.
I'm like taken a little bit. Which is, Yaka knows that rarely am I speechless. So yeah, you've definitely, I think I'm also nervous because, like, you're so smart that, like, I don't want you to catch me. I feel like you're way smarter than me, and everyone knows it. And so I'm trying to tread lightly, because, like, you could probably, but you're humble at the same time. And so it's a really nice atmosphere you create.
Yeah, thank you.
Russ, I wouldn't know how that looks. So,
oh, me being quiet because it doesn't exist. Yeah. There's no universe where I stop talking. Even in my sleep, exactly. I'm just like, "What up, guys?" It's my wife's like, "Please turn him off." All right, back to the spotlight.
Back to spotlight. Yes.
So, I love this. You want to explain it or?
I can do a short explanation. So I was looking, or I when I started this piece, at first I just wanted to practice drawing naturalistic portraits. So I googled a lot of portraits, and suddenly I came across a portrait of Lady Gaga. So I started to draw it, and so the painting or the drawing you see, this is based on the face of Lady Gaga. That's a special portrait of her, which I really liked. I'm not sure whether you can still see Lady Gaga in the face. I wouldn't say so, but a lot of friends asked me, like, "Oh my God, is it Lady Gaga?"
And I
was
tell Jeff about this one, because Jeff has a special relationship with said person, so maybe we can deliver this to her.
That would be fucking crazy.
No, man, like, they're kind of on first name basis, so, or at least I don't know. Like, I know that they know each other really well. So if she could get this piece of art, that would be incredible. Because it really is, like, I think she would get it too.
Yeah, I hope so.
Wow. I would love to facilitate that. So we need to get Jeff involved. Wow. I want one, so maybe I shouldn't make this a thing. Because if she gets one, then how many? Is it a one of one, or?
No, I think it's going to be, they're going to be 10 copies.
Oh, good.
Of the 2D version, and I guess 3 copies of the animated version. Yeah, but I'm not 100% sure.
Okay. Well, don't tell anyone. Just tell me when it's on the market. We'll make it really easy. I'll just go in there, buy everything. truly though, like, this is, I really do hope we can actually make her aware of this, because it's like, I don't know, it's really good. Like, I would be so flattered if someone, like, were used me as, like, a model to do something like this. It's insane.
Thank you.
I'm gonna try and move on. Here we go.
So here you see, it's the biggest painting I made so far. So this one is still hanging in my living room. So the original physical artwork, and it's called The Characters of Insanity. So during my studies, it should be like 2 or 3 years back when I was in my bachelor degree, I worked in a closed psychiatric hospital.
What?
To take care of it was like a student job to take care of patients. Wait, with different diseases. Like,
28 years old.
Mm-hmm.
This blows my mind. You carry yourself like if I would say you've got a soul that's like 55. Like, that's how, like, I feel like you've got an old spirit, for sure.
Yeah, thank you. So, yeah, I think I made a lot of very valuable and good or bad experience during my life, which, yeah.
I know you come from depth, so, like, you care a lot because you've seen a lot.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
So, and I grew up in a very privileged environment.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. And to see people struggling with those kind of problems. Yeah.
Still in the privileged areas?
Again, sorry.
Oh, in the privileged. So you said you're raised in a privileged environment.
Like,
were these issues, like, was everyone, like, still struggling with the same stuff no matter what, you know? Like, what status they were at? Or is this a unique experience?
This is kind of a unique experience, I guess. So I'm focusing right now on the experience I had during this during the job in the psychiatric hospital. Because I always had family around me, and I never really had to care about things a lot of other people had to care about. Doesn't mean that my family is rich, but yeah, we have a good life, and I grew up in a very friendly and warm environment.
I see what you mean.
So many people, especially during my job in the closed psychiatric hospital I had to take care for, which had experience I can't even imagine. So this was a very valuable experience for me, which definitely changed my life.
Wow.
And and in the painting you see a kind of a selection of different characters I met on my job.
Yeah.
Gathered in in a kind of psychedelic scenery with hidden characters also, and showing different characters with different emotions and different backgrounds.
Wow.
So that's the main inspiration behind this kind of artwork.
I would love to see like a time lapse. I mean, I don't even know if you'd have to that'd be a crazy experience in itself. But it's like the final work is already like so much of a crazy experience. Like I don't even know if a time lapse would add anything onto the final. Like it's like you already get such an immersive and incredible experience just at the end.
Did someone ring my name?
Oh, there he is. I want to show
What's
you.
What's going on, everybody?
Jeff, let me show you something. Let me show you. Watch my stream real fast and tell me if you know who this is.
I already know who it is.
Yeah, and I was like, maybe Jeff could somehow get this to her. I don't know, man. Like, I'm just saying, I think she would love it. So, I don't know.
I think she would love that too. And I think when we're dealing with A-list celebrities, we trend very carefully, very patiently.
I would just love to see the reaction on her face if she like saw this, because I'm like, man, this is incredible.
Dude, don't be fooled. I think a lot of people out there and a lot of celebrities are very in tune with what's going on right now. I mean, especially because of the dollar signs that are flying around with people. You know, we've seen makeup artists come in, we've seen, you know, music artists, we've seen movie stars, we've seen athletes. I think people are very keen on, you know, what NFTs are, especially the digital art sector, but it could be, who knows? You know, I think a lot of people are building stuff behind the scenes that we don't know. And I think at that point is when you want to step in and say, well, hey, you know, take a peek at this. You know, I'm not saying we did it better, but yeah, we kind of did.
I mean, we have incredible talent like that. That's why I was like already like jumping the gun. I'm like, wait a minute, there are some synergies here. And like, I was actually I'm hook, line, and sinker on this piece. I would buy it either way, like for me, and I'm glad there's 10 of them. But like, this is like one of those art pieces I would probably print out because it speaks to me like that. So I'm kind of envious that she got something modeled after her. What does a commission like this cost? I'm just kidding. Like, it's incredible.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just curious to see. I mean, I think we're just scratching the surface with NFTs and celebrities and influence, et cetera. But I think I just hope they make themselves accessible the way others have made themselves accessible so far.
Yeah, that is true. Like, I can understand how this space is intimidating. So, if you're listening, Lady Gaga, like, we'll teach you the ropes.
You happen to be tuning in,
yeah. This is your face. We want to deliver this piece to you. Or I don't know. I'm actually speaking for, you know, like our artist here. And so I'm not even, he may be like, nah, man, we have to just to pay for that. So anyway, yeah, I won't get hung up. I'm actually impressed. Did someone message you like, hey, Russ is like name dropping here?
No. Someone at me. I'm working on final edits for my TED speech, which is like due tomorrow.
Oh,
and I'm panicking, freaking out. But I figured I could take, you know, 30 seconds to jump in here.
So yeah,
everybody, Clockworky, what's going on? Hope you're doing well. But Yeah, Russ. I didn't want to intrude anything. I just saw a bunch of tags for my name. I'm like, what's going on?
I love how this community is like, hey, Russ is doing something. Like, go, go, go. No, this is a great community. And yeah, this is like relaxing. So I get it, man. Like, we can come in here and relax and then.
Hey, Russ, you're kind of breaking up. It sounds like you're going down the Matrix wormhole right now.
Well, I do that every day anyway. So that's my thing. Let me try to fix it. I don't know how to fix it. So hopefully it fixes itself.
Uh-oh, Russ, you're stuck in the Matrix.
Uh-oh. Is it that bad?
Keep talking.
All right.
Oh, much better.
There you go. Cool. I did something. I hacked it. We hear Russ normally. Oh. All right. Well, we're at the top of the hour, and so I wanted to save some time for the community to sort of weigh in. I know Clocky has really unpacked a lot, so I don't know. I'm going to be curious what questions people have. So if you have any questions, community, let me know and we'll get those. But if you don't, I won't blame you as well, because I feel like I'm still processing everything Clocky spoke about, which I need to memorize your difficult name. Yannick.
Yannick. Yeah, exactly.
I'm going to say it 30 times so it stays. Well, I do want to say, let me check the community chat once more. Hold on. Okay, it doesn't look like there are questions, and please let me know. I know sometimes someone will ask a question and then I'll have to scroll up if there's none.
Yeah, otherwise, if we have like 2 or 3 minutes left,
yeah,
I can check out the other artworks. So there are a few left I would really love to talk about.
Sure.
So if you could turn, if you could switch into the presentation again.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There we go.
Yeah, exactly. So there you see on the right side the mannequin, which I already talked about. This is part of the same portrait study series like Helmut. You remember him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so yeah, exactly. So there's another third one, but it's not mentioned in this presentation. So, but this kind of artwork is part of the other series. And on the right side, you see the Grumpy Punk.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure whether you can locate him. So if you look into the center, you see, just look into the center and go a little bit to the upper right corner. There you see like the face is half blue, it's light blue, half white. And then you have the green and pink Iroquois haircut. So this is a Grumpy Punk.
Huh. Wow.
I'm not sure whether you can see it, but yeah.
I mean, I'm trying. Tell me which way to go with my mouse.
Yeah, so, okay, I don't see your mouse anymore.
Oh, no! I think it's, like, exciting sort of trying to discover it on your own. So I may just come back to this one and try and like find it like without any instruction. It's like kind of fun.
Yeah.
It's like those Where's Waldo books, but way more in depth. It's like, where's your, I don't even know what to call it. Like, find the message.
Yeah. Wow. So this is a painting of the size of 80 centimeters and 1 meter. So it's a bit bigger.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Wow. The mannequin.
Some more abstract stuff.
Like, what's so funny is, like, it's hard for me to do these spotlights with abstract stuff because I look at the art and I want to just take a moment to interpret it myself, but then it's like, I still have to, you know, we still have to do the show.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to click. It's hard to move on, man. I promise you, I feel like every slide, it's like a little bit difficult. Like, I just need to have all these displayed in my room so I don't feel like bad from moving on.
Yeah. No, it's fine. It's fine. So on the left side, you see a fluid painting, or it's made with fluid medium and acrylic colors. And I call it the Reaper because the pink shape on the right side of the image looks to me like a Reaper. And this one's going to get animated too. And on the right side, you see the artwork, Take Your Seat. And Take Your Seat was already available in the black and white version on the Terra Virtual Marketplace. And yeah, this is original painting mixed up with a drawing, with an ink drawing. And it symbolizes it shows a psychedelic space scenery where pigs took over the human society. So in this kind, you can decide for yourself whether you would like to take place on the chair on the right. Then you get observed by an UFO and you get transferred into kind of a slaughter factory where the pigs are doing the same shit what humans are doing to pigs nowadays the whole time. Yeah, and on the right hand side, on the left hand side, you also have the option to choose the chair with the green leg. So it's in the left corner next to the bottom. Yeah. And then you get observed by kind of a brain eating tool, and afterwards you get transferred into kind of crazy factory which turns your body into money.
Wow.
So this is behind this kind of artwork.
I feel like I have to drink a whole cup of coffee and then take on one of your pieces. Has anyone else said something like that? Like, I have to make sure, like, I need to be like mentally present before I even try to absorb like all the things going on in your work.
I heard kind of those kind of things. Yeah, for sure.
Like, I have to be like in a certain mental state to really appreciate it, like in its full capacity. I almost want to just like sometimes I like want to take my time and not, you know, because we only have so much time in this art spotlight. Like, I don't want to take my own time to really explore these. Wow. Anyway, like I love that you can like take us on a journey through these pieces, and you literally just outlined where to look to, and you, it's funny because like you memorized all these different locations because you probably spent a lot of time in the different locations. So it's kind of like second nature to you to give that story. That just adds to the value so much. Cause I know that you really do care about like each and every one of these pieces, like immensely because of the amount of time you spend on just the smaller areas themselves. Golly. Like, it's, you know, what's so funny is I don't even care how long one of these takes you. Like, I usually, that's one of the questions we ask, but like, I don't know. Like, it's just, it seems irrelevant, you know, the time. I mean, it's just because I know you took enough time to do exactly like this piece. It's kind of like one Bitcoin equals one Bitcoin. I don't know if that makes any sense at all, but time is kind of like one of those human constructs.